Start and launch. The athlete starts from a fixed position, the so-called gate. Imagine time. The gate is set by the competition jury and depends on the level of the field and the current wind conditions. The in-run length is longer or shorter. Even if it's takeoff. Many factors are decisive for an athlete's exact speed at the takeoff. The ski preparation, in-run position, and body weight. Athletes usually accelerate to a speed of around 90 kilometers per hour on normal and large hills, and around 102 kilometers per hour on flying hills before they hit the takeoff point on the so-called table. At the takeoff, athletes reach their maximum speed and launch their jump into the air with a powerful and well-timed jumping motion. Here, it's important that the movement is on point and on time, smooth, and at the right angle, so that the athlete can keep the speed he has built up in the in-run and transition quickly into the flight position. Flying. In the first seconds of the flight, athletes lose some of their speed in the transition phase. But in the second flight phase, they accelerate again to finally land with top speed, around 100 kilometers per hour on normal and large hills. Again, the exact speed depends on the athlete's individual technique. During landing, athletes not only have to deal with the high speed and the difficulty to set a stable telemark landing, but the body is also battered with G-forces around 2 to 3 Gs, depending on how long the jump is and the steepness of the landing area. Thank you.